Let's start by running the React Native Packager. Yarn start. If you followed iOS 10 installation steps and have Xcode installed, you can start an iOS simulator by pressing I as soon as the packager has started. Now I press I and the simulator starts. In the meantime, let's open the project in a code editor. The simulator has started and we navigate to App.js, the application entry point. I remove all the content from it so that we can start from scratch. In React, there are two kinds of components, functional and class components. Let's start with a functional component, which is just a function returning a React element. So it will be function hello return text and inside React Native Academy. This strange syntax that looks just like HTML is called JSX. It is an extension to JavaScript and produces React elements. It shows in code how the components are structured in a nice visual way. JSX code is translated into standard JavaScript syntax by a tool called Babel. Let's navigate to Babel web page and see how it works. I copy our functional component and at the Babel web page, I select try it out and paste the code. This JSX syntax is a shorthand for React create element call. It takes three parameters: text, a React component, its properties, which are empty here, and component contents. React and text are variables that we need to import to make this code work. React create element relates to component behavior, so it comes from the React package. Text is a mobile component that outputs a string on a screen, so it comes from React Native. Let's get back to the code and import the packages. Import React from React and import text from React Native. We must also export hello function so that it is visible outside the app.js file. Export default hello. Now, as you can see, React Native Academy is displayed at the top of the screen.